previously on Taylor Bell's YouTube channel.
That's me. I'm Taylor Bell. Did that sound like a legit previously on? No, it didn't? Okay. Previously on Taylor Bell's YouTube channel, I left my beautiful house, my parents' house, in sunny California to move to New York City. Okay, it wasn't like that crazy of a thing because, yeah, I moved across the country to go to college in Philadelphia for 4 years. So, you know, not my first rodeo. But it was still emotional a little bit nonetheless. I got very used to being at home, the comforts of home, for over a year after graduating from college. And I didn't want to move to New York City for my job because we didn't have to be in the office yet. So, like, save money. Anyway, I finally did it though. I did a thing. And here's how it went.
Hey, I feel like a real vlogger since I'm filming in the bathroom. I don't know what to say. I'll see you in there.
Yeah, I don't know what about filming in the airplane lavatory made me feel legit or made me feel like a vlogger. That's not even a stereotype, but that's how it felt in the moment, okay? Leave me alone. I did, however, edit a video on that flight. It kept me busy for 6 hours, or I guess 5.5 hours going east because, you know, Jetstream. Was it weird editing a video of myself front and center on the plane, you ask? Oh, good question. Well, yeah, at first it actually was. I was like front row aisle seat. So in terms of how airplane seats go, a decent amount of people could see my screen compared to if I had like a window seat. But then I realized I put videos of myself on the internet for thousands of people to see, and I would like even more, you know, viewers. So let them watch. Turn the brightness all the way up on my laptop too. Please give this video a thumbs up for the dedication. And before I knew it, as I finished up editing that video, we were on our final approach into JFK Airport. Kind of crazy they named a president after an airport, right? That was a joke. So I took a taxi from JFK to Manhattan instead of the train because I was checking two huge 50-pound bags plus a roller, like, carry-on. So just bit the bullet, took a taxi, but I actually didn't really mind. I got to see a beautiful view of the skyline, which never really gets old for me. And it was the first time I'd seen it in, I guess, not that long. I was only there 3 months before, but still. I finally got to my apartment. It was 1:30 in the morning, and for the sake of this video, I just wish that I took one of those shots where you go in and you set the camera up beforehand, obviously, and then you open the door and, you know, it's like, I'm home. Yeah, I didn't take a video like that, but I did get the bed sheets out of my suitcase. That was the first thing I unpacked, and I made my bed real nice and cozy for my first sleep there. If you're wondering why my apartment was furnished, because I'm sure you're all wondering that. I actually signed the lease on this place 3 months before I moved in, and then I sublet it to a friend for that time. So before she moved in, I went to New York to see the place and get it furnished for the most part. So I already had my bed frame, my mattress, some lamps, you know, light fixtures, some bookshelves, stuff that I left there 3 months before. So that answers your burning question. I swear this is the most efficient way to get from one side of the bed to the other, and it's just kind of fun.
I've had baby since I was 2 years old. When I first went to college, my parents were wondering if I was too old to bring baby with me. I was 18. Now I'm 24. She's staying.
I'm not fucking leaving!
Okay, guys, that was part one. This is part two. A quick chit-chat, if you will.
Swiss custom requires 10 minutes of blah, blah, blah.
Chit-chat.
Yeah, chit-chat, thank you, before business can be discussed.
A lot of Wolf of Wall Street references today, huh? Obliterate the like button down below for Margot Robbie and Wolf of Wall Street. Obliterate. Okay, first thing. I feel like I haven't done a little chit-chat on my channel in a while, but why did I move to New York? Like, actually, why did I choose to move to a city across the country from where I'm from my family? And this won't just be about me and my reasoning. Me, me, me. I'll hopefully have some words of wisdom in here for people of all ages, so listen up. All right, but the first reason I moved is because, admittedly, a large portion of my friends from Penn, my alma mater, moved to New York City after we graduate from college because a lot of us go into finance and consulting jobs, which New York is just really big for. And while that might sound like a bad reason, the whole I did it because everyone else does it, one should not overlook how important and I guess helpful it is to have a support system of friends and just people that you know in the city that you live in. So I guess in that way, I have a little bit of a leg up in the sense that I don't have to make a whole host of new friends, although of course it's good to always be making new friends. But I guess I'm just saying that I do know people there. It, you know, I have a support system, so that's very nice. And the other reason I moved, and this is the, I guess, most important reason, and this is probably the part where I'm gonna sound a little bit like I'm trying to be a life advice guru, so bear with me. There is this place called your comfort zone. I'm sure you've heard of her. And while the comfort zone is a nice and warm and comfy place to be, typically things extraordinary don't happen there. This is something we talked a lot about during my leadership program in college. Shout out Wharton Leadership Ventures. But you have your comfort zone, your growth zone, and your panic zone. Now, in terms of living arrangements, my comfort zone is being at home with my parents and my dogs. I love it. There's nothing wrong with it. It's where I am right now for the holidays. It's great. The growth zone for me is like living in a different city where I know some people and I can speak the native language, wherever that may be. But being away from my family and my best friend, having a new job and learning how to navigate that city, and being totally financially independent, of course. And that's what I'm doing right now. And if you're curious, panic zone for me, again, in terms of like long-term living arrangements, would be living in an unsafe place where I don't speak the native language and I don't know a single person. You don't want to be in your panic zone. So all of that is to say, this diagram that I'll probably put together, you should try to put yourself in your growth zone a decent amount of the time, because if you're not growing, then you're staying stagnant and, you know, what's the point? So moving to New York is in my growth zone for sure. In fact, I was thinking just the other day about how different my life would be if I chose to go to UCLA or USC, which are two really, really good universities here in Los Angeles, where I'm from. I think I absolutely would have loved both of them. Again, great schools. They're both really fun. I know a lot of people at them, but I also bet that I would have been in my comfort zone a lot more because a lot of the aspects of my life would have remained the same. So going to an Ivy League university on the East Coast, where I pretty much knew zero people at the school. I mean, I knew a couple, but we were in different circles and I literally never saw them. Anyway, that was definitely a growth experience for me. Studying abroad was a growth experience, and I know a lot of people do that. It's not this insane, crazy thing. But when you really think about what it is and what it entails, for me, living in Spain for 6 months and only taking classes in Spanish, definitely a growth experience. Anyway, this isn't a job interview, but when I look back on those experiences, the ones that were in my growth zone, those are really the times when I feel like I developed as an individual, when I became more independent, learned something new, etc. I think you get the idea. So I would personally encourage everyone watching this video to at some point, well, not just at some point, but a lot of the time, make sure that you're putting yourself in your growth zone. And what that may look like to you is very likely very different than what that looks like to me. I'm so not saying you have to move very, very far away from your family or across the country to grow as a person, but you know, give it some thought what that might look like to you, and I'm sure it will do you some good. Another reason that I moved to New York is that it's a good place to film YouTube content. Totally kidding. I interviewed for jobs in New York long before I ever had a YouTube channel, but that is a lucky byproduct, I guess. I mean, even though people love to shit on New York, myself included, I mean, it's expensive as hell, it's dirty. People seem to think that the person in front of them in gridlock traffic will be able to move faster if they lay on their horns for 20 seconds straight right outside my apartment window. Besides these things, it's a really special city and it does have that energy and the hustle and bustle that people talk about. And while that's not for everyone, I think that it is a pretty inspiring place to be. And there's just something about it that draws you in, I guess. So hopefully that helps me make good YouTube content. It's a work hard, play hard city for sure. I know that isn't a cheesy expression, but it is. And that makes it a good place to be in my early 20s. And while I love nature and fresh air and hiking and climbing and all that good stuff, and I fully intend to have a nice house with a big backyard, I have a few years under my belt before I do that, so. And part three of this video, or I guess something I just wanna say, is thank you, seriously, you watching this video. I hit 20,000 subscribers recently, and it just blows my mind how many people that is, and only like 5 of them are family members, and one of them is my other Gmail account, and one of them, in all seriousness, whether this is your first time watching me or you've been around since the beginning, thank you, I appreciate it, it means the world. And now that I'm a bit more settled in my New York life, I've been there for 2 months now, I'm very excited to put out a whole lot more content in 2022 than I have been the last 6 months, so stay tuned. With that, please demolish the like button down below for $0 if you enjoyed this video whatsoever. I would appreciate it, and I'll see you guys very soon in New York, or actually here in LA for the holidays, although I'll be here for a little bit, but I'll see you guys soon. Oh, check out my Christmas cup. Coffee bean, cappuccino. Cheers to that. Bye.